Hey, humans. Welcome back. We will turn this pencil drawing from 2017 into a colored painting without much effort. From the sketch into this decent colored painting using a bunch of multiply, overlay, and hard light layers. First, we will add base layer. We will use clipping group to all other layers so the colored area will follow the space. For this coloring method, the base color need to be white, but you can choose any other color first and turn it white later, so it'll be easier to see. Make sure to use a hard brush without opacity jitter, or you can use lasso tool. Having a bit of transparency here will be a problem later. I made that mistake here, so I had to redo the base again. Lastly, make sure to turn the base into white. Really important! Now get into the second step. We will use a multiply layer to color from this grayscale. You can make a single multiply layer and color it normally. But the downside is, it will be hard to tweak the color, and this coloring method require a lot of tweak later. The other way is to make each separate multiply layer for each part and each color. But if you color it overlapped, the color will be different since you are using multiply layer. So you need to color it carefully. So which method is the best? This is what I like to do. I make a group layer and set that to multiply. Then I make some normal layer for each part or color per layer and put them inside the group. So inside the group layer, there are layers for skin color, hair color, and eye color. By doing this, all the normal layer will be combined first, then it will become multiplied from the group. So you will be safe from overlapped multiply layer, and you can tweak the color later easily. To choose the color, I think it's the same as normal base color, but you need to pick the brighter color. Well, you still can change the color later easily, so you can pick any fine color now. Now the third step. This one is a bit optional. You don't need to do this if your pencil drawings already have good contrast or value. For me, I took the picture using iPhone 4S. It's a bit bad and outdated, so I will try to improve it a bit. I duplicated the sketch layer and paint on it. Think like drawing in grayscale, the value training thingy. The most important contrast is the eye, so that's the first thing I do. This is what I like to do to draw eyes. The top and bottom part are bright. The bottom is always bright in most styles. And the top one is for the reflection, mostly from the sky. I also make the edge inside a bit bright. This brings up the shininess. And remember the extra white dot inside there. It's like the most important thing when drawing eyes. Then I darken the edges, kind of like redoing the shading. Using airbrush works well on this. Actually, I use airbrush for everything here. Fourth step. Now we back to coloring. This is the problem with using multiply layer to coloring. It will look dead, dull, lifeless, grayish. We will use an overlay layer to counter this. You can put it on top or below the multiply layer. And remember the clipping group. Simply use bucket tool and color it using red-orange color around middle of first quarter there. And again, if you are not used with this method, you will need to do a lot of changes. You can press Ctrl plus U to change hue saturation thing. Basically, you don't want it to bright. It will remove the shading you made. Then change the saturation till the color looks less dull. This should change the shading color so it's having proper color. Now it's a bit better than a multiply only. Next, the fifth step. So far we have used multiply and overlay layers. We will use hard light layer to give more color. The layer will be placed on the top. You can use airbrush for this. Pick red color, low saturation, and 50% brightness. Then airbrush it lightly everywhere. Mostly around the shadows, and around nose and cheek. We also can color the lip here instead on the multiply. Adding those redness should give more life to the skin. Human skin has a lot of subtle red everywhere. This hard light is actually similar to overlay layer. With 50% brightness, it will only add color. More than that, it will brighten, and less than that, it will darken. So we can use this for everything, like adding those hair specular or highlight. Also give more depth to the shadow. to add secondary lighting from the side. It's like my most favorite thing to do. You can call it a cheat to make painting a bit more interesting. Adding more highlight, especially on a lonely lip. I also like to add highlight on the corner of nose, also around the upper lip. I decided to improve the grayscale a bit more. I think it's a bit too bright now. Not enough contrast after I add in those lights. After that, I go back to my hard light layer to give more color to those new shadows. I make a new hard light layer to give more extreme bright, so it will be safe if it turns bad. You can make these layers multiple times, it should be do the same. And I think the skin is a bit too white, so make a multiply layer on top. I color it using orange skin tone, then reduce the opacity of that layer. So it looks a bit more normal now. Then, I also use this multiply layer to add more shading but using colors, like more blue tone to the shadow. Now, is this the 6 steps? Technically, you can do this on your hard light layer, but I like to paint normally with one layer. I try to add more light. Also make proper secondary light from the side using blue color. This blue is actually not a blue. It's more to red but with low saturation. Color is relative to its surrounding. For finishing touch, I use an overlay layer. I think it's the most powerful layer. It can instantly make your painting more popping. I use airbrush and give bright orange color. Also, remember the clipping group so it will stays inside the painting. For the true final step, we will use Liquify to fix the shapes. Since this was a 2017 drawing, there are a lot of mistakes here. You actually can do this on the beginning before we start. But I do this last as a scenario from the previous video. Make sure to watch it to learn how to use Liquify to unclip Studio Paint. And this should be the last part of this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like and comment if you find this video helpful. Subscribe for more art stuff. You know, like a speed paint and tutorials.